So this is the Bowen house, all right? Nell and Tate Bowen lived here from 1965 to 1995. So that's 30 years in this house.
So they loved it.
They loved it.
Three bedrooms, two baths, 1,800 square feet, and it's listed for $135,000.
Ben and I have always kind of had a little crush on this house.
This house feels like a historic house, but with all the privacy and nature that living in the country gives you. It's like a city house in the country.
Kind of a little concerned about the front falling
a
little bit.
It's trying to slide off the house.
It looks sad.
It doesn't seem to be a structural concern.
Okay. I don't love the green.
Yeah, there's so much green on the front. I mean,
there's not enough contrast.
Right, for sure.
We know you don't like the color, and so we wanted to show you what was possible.
I have a painting that I think might really make you happy.
All right.
Wow. It could be painted this kind of gray, blue, navy color.
Right.
I think that would be really pretty against this crisp white. That's always such a classic color combination.
Yeah, that was great.
The house needs a new roof, so we would need to replace that. And I'm thinking something that's like a weathered gray-brown. The thing I'm most excited about is we tear down the droop and give you a natural wood pergola just around the front door, kind of a little trellis.
Yeah, that'll look good.
A new light fixture at the front door, paint the steps. I think it would look really lovely, especially if we cleaned up the landscaping a little. So what do you think?
It's beautiful.
Now, the thing about this is aluminum siding, and it's very expensive to paint. First, we'd have to come in with an etching primer and then use a special paint to coat it. It's a lot. It would be about $35,000 on the exterior.
Okay.
I like having that. The woodsy tone over the door should blend in well with the atmosphere and outside too.
Yeah, we like wood tones.
I do too. We're gonna start demo on the Adams house today. And the great thing is, it's really just like one room and a deck.
Yeah, the previous owners already demoed the floor for us.
Thanks, guys.
Everything's going.
Yep, everything.
Let's start here though. Maybe there's floor under here.
I feel like we're gonna find plywood. I feel sure of it.
With linoleum.
Yeah. Well, that's fine, you Debbie Downers. I'll be the last shining light.
Demoing the floor in the kitchen. We've got 1995 to 97.
I think it's about a 99.
Oh, you think they got it on discount on closeout?
I do. I think it was a 1999 closeout tile. I think beneath that we're gonna have some vinyl or linoleum, and then we're gonna hit the plywood. I'll be dadgum. It's not plywood. It's fine. I don't know if it's like usable wood, but it is wood. It is nice.
We have tongue and groove wood flooring.
It's very unexpected.
Do you feel validated, Katie?
More than ever. Thank you, guys.
Yeah.
Just what kind of purpose you think that serves?
I need to run a plate of Joy 630 Mississippi.
It serves some kind of purpose.
They're trying to keep mice out. Okay, what are we gonna do? Take the license plate off your mama's car.
All the paint is happening so fast. The dining room is done. It's a gray because that is what Jennifer loves, but you gotta be careful with gray. You don't want it to go purple. A warmer gray is always better.
Mr. David's at Jennifer and Casey's house. He's doing all the tile.
I love this grout. It seems subtle, but you can see where it's not grouted and then where the grout begins. It feels so connected to the cabinet color.
And this countertop also has that same, just about exact color.
And Jennifer loves a gray and white kitchen. I want to give her that, but I also want to make sure it doesn't feel cold. So like the beams, that's adding warmth to the room. I love how they turned out. They look so good.
They look great.
The ceiling beams are in, and they look awesome.
I knew I should have went this morning.
Yeah, and then the floors, that's another big component in warming it up.
And
they're
this
here.
This is your floor.
Yeah.
Hexagons.
I love these. It's gonna be really pretty with the beams.
What are the floor tiles?
They're like a Saltillo tile, but hexagon.
Oh
no!
Gosh.
It's gonna be so good! Because everything feels really like white and gray and sterile right now, but the floor tile and the beams.
The warmth. I'm out. I'll see y'all later. I'm gonna go look at the beams.
I love the front porch.
Oh, it looks so good.
Landscaping is gone. You can see the house now. Yeah, the roof looks good. The copper gutters are great.
And the green.
Yeah, the green looks really good.
You like the green. It looks good.
You can actually see it.
It's such a pleasing shade of green. And I love anytime we can help people fall in love with what they already have.
Yeah.
You just needed some contrast. And the rain chain was our solution to, like, you.
I've always wanted a rain
really?
Chain.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm so glad
we
you
got
say
one now.
That. I love how woodsy it feels. To me, it feels like you.
Yeah, it feels like it was supposed to always look this way.
The inside is just gorgeous.
Stunning.
I'm excited.
Yeah, come on in.
Wow, look at this. This is awesome.
It is beautiful.
That's a whole other house.
My style, for sure.
Yeah, it looks great.
The floors were a huge undertaking.
Okay.
Yeah, I bet.
We took a couple pieces and had this milled to match. But the original floors are about three different sizes.
It's very subtle.
So that's fun to put together.
It's very subtle, and it was impossible. Like, we started.
Right.
So we picture framed it. You can see over there by the hearth.
Yeah, okay.
But allowed us to be able to come in and do the oak floors to match it.
Yeah, it looks awesome.
Love it.
Remember when we were here looking at the house and some of the flooring was laying out on the deck in the back? That's where your coffee table came from.
Oh, wow. Man, I didn't even notice it.
It's a much more prettier coffee table.
Man, I love the colors of this stained glass on here too.
I worked with an artist named Kenneth to make this just for you. I took some of your vacation photos from Lake Lanier and a few other places in Georgia. And the thing I love about this piece is your room is pretty neutral. This is really the only colorful moment that happens, and it only happens with the sunlight. I hope that it makes you think of all your good times on the water.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
Let's go see the dining room.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Man, look at this.
It's beautiful.
Oh, this looks great. The curtains and everything looks good.
You like?
Yes. Everything flows so good into here.
How do you feel about the color?
I love the
color. I like
it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All we changed was the color and the light.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. Beautiful.
I love how we keep talking about the dining room. Really, all you care about is the kitchen. Well, you're like dying to see it.
Yeah.
Dying to see it.
Go to the kitchen.
Okay.
Go on in.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Look at this, honey. Golly, this is something else.
That looks so good.
That's a lot to take in, man. This is great.
Look at the floor.
I love the floor. Do you love it?
I love the floor.
Golly, this is awesome.
It's beautiful.
I love the ceiling too.
Yeah. I love the beams and the nook. I love that.
Yeah.
The nook is everyone's favorite.
God, it's completely different than what it was.
It's very hard to remember even what
it's
it was.
It's so before. Hard to remember.
Wow.
I know you gravitate toward a white kitchen.
Yeah.
And I wanted to give you that, but also didn't want to lose the warmth. That became a real theme in everything we were doing with the terracotta on the floors in here, the beams on the ceiling, the wood in the little mud bench area. Those moments matter so much in breaking up white so it doesn't feel cold.
The room feels bigger. It was big before and it felt big, but it feels really big now.
And we didn't make the room bigger, we just changed the traffic.
I just think about like holidays too. Thanksgiving, you can have it all here and circle through. And
This is the buffet.
It's a great flow, absolutely, yeah.
We were able to give you so much more custom storage by giving you this little mud room on this wall, and we have a really special hidden secret drawer.
Oh.
Yeah. Look at this.
Oh,
isn't
that
best?
Yeah.
We just wanted to get like use out of every inch of your kitchen. And we gave you a new doggy door, which seems like a natural segue. You want to see the backyard?
Yeah.
We don't have to go through the doggy
door. No, we
okay,
don't.
Great.
We use the doorknob and everything.
Y'all come on out.
Oh, man.
Oh, my gosh.
This is great.
Oh, my gosh. We have a fireplace outside.
Isn't that awesome?
What a backyard.
We have a fireplace outside.
And the awning's gone.
Yeah.
The awning's
no
gone.
No camper awning.
Yeah.
Oh, looks good.
Look at this.
You like that?
I yeah, love this it. Is awesome.
I built a bench in my wood shop. So I had to call my brother that's a mathematician because I had to get these angles correct. Because I wanted it to fit with the fireplace here.
Yeah.
Well, he done great. You done great.
Thank you. I did all the work.
He just
he did
you
the
numbers.
Math.